appreciate that kind of reception. I hope you appreciate the beauty of the London Sportman as well. How often does an old man get to do that?
I'm very happy to be here. I'm here for a very special reason, and that's to present the Spirit of Hammer Award to someone that you might not expect. And I want to tell you why this guy is, in our opinion, worthy of this incredible award. He is truly a god of heavy metal, but in a very different way. He's called Dr. Matt Taylor. Already know, this man has done something extraordinary which has never in the history of man been done before. He and his team hurled a large piece of metal and silicon 300 million miles into space and landed a small pod on a comet. Unusual. The thing took 10 years. So 10 years ago, people planned this out. They launched the thing. For 10 years, they didn't even speak to it because it had to rest. And then they just hoped that when it switched itself on, it would be in the right place. It wasn't the right place. Now, you probably think this guy is some very important American. He's not. He's British. He was born here. Yards from here, in fact. He spent most of his youth in the East End. He went to Liverpool University to get his physics degree, and he went to Imperial College to get his doctorate. It's very close to my heart. In case you don't know, I'm going to tell you what Rosetta is. This mission. It's something which has never been done before, and it's only a few. It was last November that the vehicle wound up at the comet that it had been pursuing for 10 years. This guy, Dr. Matt Taylor, was in control of the whole thing. He's a very unusual guy. I've been talking to a lot of people who worked for him, and they say he's a very nice guy. He's also a guy who does not take any shit, and that's an essential quality. He's also a guy who has more tattoos than the whole of us lot put together. And he's the guy who is not afraid to show that. He's also one of the few guys who has tattoos on one part of his body, the dogs of war, and on another part of his body, he has Albert Einstein. There ain't many people with that distinction. I just want to say it's my honor to present him with this award. But there's a postscript. Let me tell you this. Rosetta arrived and rendezvoused with a comet. A little piece of stuff detached itself and landed on the comet. It bounced a couple of times, but then it transmitted back the first pictures ever sent from the surface of a comet. It then unfortunately went to sleep because it landed in some shadow, and so its solar power couldn't recharge its batteries. The timing of this is incredible because just yesterday, the damn thing woke up. So this little thing called Philae is about to transmit more messages back to Earth, and it's incredible. So it makes it very happy for me. Apparently, this is my favourite Twitter of the day. My favourite tweet of the day is, today Philae woke up after a 6-month sleep. Its message was, good morning. I feel great. All is good. But what the fuck happened on May the 7th? It's my only joke, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure and pride to bestow the equivalent of a heavy metal knighthood, the Spirit of the Hammer of the Golden Gods, on Dr. Matt Taylor.
Thank you.
what he's been doing. I can't say much, well, probably will say much, but I'm honoured to receive this. Other people that have received this are people like Brian Blessed, and he would say... Yeah!
Filet's alive!
You know what? I'm like you. All of you, I'm a metalhead. And you can all land something on a comet. That's all I want to say to you guys. Just never stop dreaming. It doesn't matter what you look like. Just keep on doing shit, doing what you want to do. Keep dreaming. It'll happen. And stay metal.
Matt, you're actually working for your beer tonight.
Ryan, I can't let you leave the stage. There's another award. It's for Riff Lord. Stay in school.